عليكم السلام دكتور.
السلام دكتور.
Our lecture today is about carcinoma of the prostate. I think the benign prostatic hyperplasia presented by one of my colleagues, isn't it? انطوكم محاضرة بي بي اتش؟
نعم دكتور.
من انطاها دكتور مازن وعلي؟
دكتور مازن.
Okay. Now we will talk about the carcinoma of the prostate. I think if he gave you the PBH, he probably talk about the anatomy of the prostate. You know that the prostate is located at the neck of your inner bladder, and it is rested on the membranous membrane, and it is normally about 20 to 25 gram in weight. And it is, as you know, it's sexual organ. It forms about 30% of the seminal fluid. And the prostate is a common in benign tumor and common as malignant tumor. But the malignancy of the prostate, or what called the CA prostate, is a little bit slowly growing. There are a lot of cases with CA prostate and they are dormant. However, it is common, but it is not a common cause of mortality because it is a slowly growing tumor. And differ from other tumor that it measured by 10-year survival. The other tumor is measured by 5-year survival. But because it is indolent or slowly growing tumor, it's measured by 10-year survival. And there are a lot of cases of CA prostate. However, they have CA prostate, but manage conservatively. Okay, we'll talk according to the system of the lecture. You know, carcinoma of the prostate, this is that it's located in the below the bladder neck and rested on the membranous membrane. This membranous membrane is formed the external sphincter. You know that we have internal sphincter, which is formed by the prostate itself and cushion of the mucous membrane surrounding the prostate. And we are continent normally by the internal sphincter, which is the prostate. That's why when we remove the prostate, we depend mainly on the external sphincter. So you have to preserve the external sphincter during prostate surgery. Otherwise, your patient, he may have urinary incontinence. These are the top 10 cancer diagnosed worldwide. CA prostate is the first. CA prostate is the first. But as I said to you, it's first in the incidence, but it is not first in mortality because it is a slowly growing and indolent tumor. And a lot of cases of post-mortem studies find that they have CA prostate, which is harmful or asymptomatic for these patients. In our society, it is not so common. In our society, the CA prostate is not so common. It's more common in Western countries. As you see in this diagram, the incidence of the lung, bladder, leukemia, non-Hodgkin lymphoma, brain, larynx, skin, melanoma, stomach, and the CA prostate is coming late in the list. It's one of the most common cancer in the world. And there are risks. What are the risk factor for CA prostate? The risk factor for benign prostatic hyperplasia or the CA prostate is there are two main factors. It's the age. The age is the most important. As Dr. Mazen said to you that when the hair becomes scanty and gray, when there is a matter of specks of earthy matter on the tunica of the artist, that's atheroma, as there's an arcus sinulus which is formed around the cornea, the prostate usually, if not invariably, enlarged. So it is a disease of aging process. Age, the risk factor, race is more common in Negroes, that and the family history, it's run in genetic. If we are searching for CA prostate in patient above 50, but if he had family history, we have to search in earlier. High dietary fat intake and obesity also are one of the risk factors, and the smoking as in many other diseases. This is the anatomy of the prostate. It had three zones, the peripheral zone, transitional zone, and central zone. Central zone, which is surrounding the ejaculatory duct. The transitional zone is surrounding the urethra, while the peripheral zone is on periphery. The CA prostate, 70% occur in the peripheral zone, and 20% in the transitional zone, and 10% in the central zone. While the penile prostatic hyperplasia, BPH, exclusively in the transitional zone, it affecting only the transitional zone. So the CA prostate in the peripheral zone, small nodule here, which can be palpated by digital rectal exam. That's why survey for to be enlarged too close. This is the urethra. So this is the yellow one is the urethra. And this is the peripheral zone. This is the site of formation. To reach the urethra and occlude the urethra and causing bladder outlet obstruction, it needs to be large tumor. That's why, and if we are waiting for patient with CA prostate to be presented for obstructive symptom, it means it's late and bad prognosis. So we have to search for CA prostate, and the two main tools to search for CA prostate is the digital rectal exam and the prostate specific antigen, which is a tumor marker. The pathology, 90%, 95% of CA prostate are adenocarcinoma, rarely transitional cell carcinoma, which is form about 90% of the remaining 5%. The diagnosis of carcinoma of the prostate differ from any other tumor. I mean, pathologic diagnosis is depend on the architecture. As I said to you, 70% in the peripheral zone, 10 to 20 in transition, and less than 10 in the central zone. This is the pathological, what's called Gleason grade for the prostate. In other tumor, we are depending on cellular and nuclear metaplasia. But in CA prostate, we don't study the cell. We study the architecture of the prostate in general. So this is well differentiated. This is mild differentiation, now poorly differentiated, moderate, poorly or poorly differentiated. And this is anaplastic or undifferentiated from 1 to 5, according to the differentiation of glandular architecture. This is appear to be a normal glandular architecture with there's some spaces. Here the spaces is increased. This is called cribriform. Cribriform mean fenestrated gland, and the last one is completely disappearance of the glandular architecture. So these are five, and in fact, we don't find only one form of the grade, and not only of the CA prostate the same grade. Usually we find, for example, grade 1 and grade 2, or grade 2 and grade 3, and there are mixture of the grade. That's why they find what's called Gleason score. Gleason score was summation, يعني جمع of the most dominant area and the second most dominant area. And the Gleason score, إذا نجمعهن يعني أقل واحدة شقد grade 1, for example. Grade 1, إذا هي نفسها area كلها grade 1 نعطيها 1 plus 1. Grade 1 يعني صير score 2. The Gleason score 2. And if it's a grade 5, Someone raise his hand. If you have any question or shall I continue if the voice is not clear for you? Okay. Shall we continue? Do you hear me?
I'm doctor.
Am I clear?
Yes.
So the Gleason score is from 2 to 10. إذا أقل شيء واحد زائد واحد يعني إذا هي same. إذا بس grade 1 present in the. For example, if he said to you that Gleason score 3 plus 4. What it mean? It means the most dominant area here, grade 3. And the second most dominant, 4. So Gleason, واضحة هاي الفكرة واضحة لكم؟
واضحة دكتور.
جي. أكو بن ليجين اللي هو هذا نفس الـ CIS نفس كارسينوما إنسايتو in the prostate ويقسمونه إلى high grade ولو grade. Low grade usually no need to be followed إذا طلع بالهستوباثولوجي ما يحتاج كلش close observation. But a high grade is pre-malignant and need close observation. I Gleason rely on glandular architecture. There are 5 grades from well differentiated to undifferentiated glandular architecture. Gleason score who by summation of the primary and secondary area. So it is from 2 to 10 grades. And now we will come to the staging of carcinoma of the prostate. If it is discovered accidentally, either by resection, for example, for benign prostatic hyperplasia, and you send for histopathology the benign prostatic hyperplasia, and a feature of malignancy, you have no any feature of malignancy, and you find the patient have malignancy accidentally by histopathology. If it is less than, if it is less than 5% of the resected tissue, it's called stage 1A. If more than 5%, stage 1B. If only discovered by elevated prostate specific antigen, it is stage 1C. Stage 2 is confined within the prostate. Either one loop affecting 2A, two loop affecting two loops, 2B. Stage 3, يعني هذا this is by stage 2 by digital rectal exam. Stage 3 is extra capsular extension, seminal vesicle or extra capsular extension. If it is extend to the adjacent tissue, it's called stage T4. If involved lymph node N1, metastatic to regional lymph node. Look, it's differ from any other tumor. If distant lymph node, هذا M1A. If the to the bones has prediction to metastasize to the bone, especially the spinal cord, sorry, the vertebral column and the femur, pelvis, humerus, it's called M1B if only the bone. If it is distant metastasis to the other organ, it's M2. Clinical feature, most cases asymptomatic. Asymptomatic and should be discovered by surveillance because if it is presented with symptom, it means the tumor is advanced. The symptom is either obstructive or irritative when it's involving the urethra and metastatic disease if it is metastasized to the bone or spinal cord may cause bone pain and pathological fracture or it may metastasize to the lung and the brain also. the parameter to survey for CA prostate, as I said to you, is the digital rectal exam. In digital rectal exam, we find a nodule, hard nodule. The differential, not every nodule. Every nodule should be regarded as malignancy until proved otherwise. But not every nodule is malignancy. But regarded as malignancy, you deal with as malignancy until prove otherwise. The differential diagnosis, prostatitis, granulomatous prostatitis like TB or Bernhardsiasis sometime. If the patient had previous transurethral resection of the prostate or needle biopsy, probably had a hard nodule. Also, a prostatic calculus can. But as I said to you, every nodule should be regarded as malignancy, and you take biopsy from the nodule by needle biopsy. The other the investigation who you have to investigate causing obstruction and anemic as any other malignancy or chronic illness could lead to anemia, and also the bone metastasis lead to anemia because involvement of the bone marrow. And the most important tumor marker is the prostate specific antigen. Previously they used alkaline phosphatase or acid phosphatase. It's now a day. It is not used, only we are depending on the prostate specific antigen. And the prostate specific antigen is elevated not only in carcinoma of the prostate, but its presence in high number in blood, it means there is destruction of the prostate cell. Destruction can be by carcinoma or due to BPH also, it can cause elevated BSA and the infection. Differential diagnosis of high BSA is BPH, urethral instrumentation, infection, and even vigorous massage and the prostatic biopsy. But in massage, in vigorous massage, the PSA usually return to normal in about 1 month, while in, in about 1 week in massage. I teach the MCQ. In massage, it about need 1 week to return to normal. While if you are doing TURB or prostatic biopsy, needle biopsy, it need 1 month to be returned to normal. طبعاً هو BSA is present normally in the blood and is usually less than 4 nanogram per ml. But it is elevation from 4 to 10 is usually in BPH, infection, instrumentation, massage, and even TURB. But if it is remain elevated and high, especially more than 10, you have to think about malignancy. And you have to take a prostate biopsy to prove this CA prostate or infection or BPH by biopsy, and you send for histopathology, which is giving you the result. Also, other image can be used like transrectal ultrasound, which is now only used in to guiding the prostatic biopsy. MRI is also used and bone scan if there is suspicion of bone metastasis. Prostatic biopsy usually obtained under truss. When the truss transrectal ultrasound is introduced into radiologic field, they think that it will solve a lot of problem for diagnosing the CA prostate. But nowadays, the truss, transrectal truss, is used only to guide the needle in prostatic biopsy. How do we treat the CA prostate? Treatment is according to grade and the stage of the tumor and life expectancy. And for example, if patient have heart failure, for example, or myocardial infarction, and his life expectancy is less than 10 years, no need to expose this patient to major surgery, for example, radical prostatectomy, which have high mortality rate and probably you causing the death of the patient. And you have, in every surgery, you have to wait, what's in here, yani side effect of the surgery and the benefit of the surgery. A lot of cases, especially low-grade carcinoma of the prostate, is to be treated conservatively if the patient life expectancy is less than 10 years. But if you find a CA prostate in young patient or 40 year patient and he's healthy and well, you have to treat this patient by more sophisticated and invasive procedure. The Say prostate management of say prostate can be divided into localized or metastasized. And in the localized is radical prostatectomy is the best curable procedure for carcinoma of the prostate. But radiation and the brachytherapy and the cryosurgery are also used, and sometimes it's regarded as a curable and in the prognosis as the radical prostatectomy. But I think the radical prostatectomy is the best choice for localized prostate cancer within the prostate in patients have no major comorbidity that affecting his life survival. What do we mean by brachytherapy? Brachytherapy refers to the treatment technique that places radioactive source in close proximity to the tumor. وهذا ينطي radiation continuous to kill the tumor cell, which is either interstitial through the interstitium or intracavitary, which is injected into cavity like in the lumen of the urethra or cavity near the tumor itself. So there is an old idea that radical prostatectomy, radiation, and cryosurgery are comparable in result. Nowadays, there are a lot of ideas against it, and they make the radical prostatectomy is the best. In metastatic disease, a single lymph node metastasis is regarded as metastatic disease, which is beyond surgical. No need for surgical treatment in metastatic disease. You know that the carcinoma of the prostate is endocrine, is hormonal dependent, depend on testosterone. So you have to do deandrogenization. And you know that androgen is secreted 95% from the testis and 5% from the adrenal. In testis, simply either you do bilateral orchiectomy, or this is surgical, or medical by giving LHRH analog, luteinizing hormone, releasing hormone analog, which is abolish the stimulation of the Leydig cell to secrete hormone. It's either medical or surgical. Surgical by orchiectomy and medical by LHRH analog, which is available in the market in the name of Zoladex. Ambul, ينطى شهريا, subcutaneous, وهذا يسوي suppression of the luteinizing hormone, which is stimulate the secretion of testosterone. But in the first few weeks, it have surge, and we saw stimulation in the first few weeks, then it returned to zero level of the hormone. Testicular hormone, gonna 95% of the testosterone, we have blocked by surgical or medical. But as I said to you, LHRH cause increased testosterone release in the first few weeks, and who is so stimulation. Later on, there will be abolish or neglection of the testosterone. But still, the peripheral receptor of the testosterone can be blocked by other drug like flutamide or bicalutamide, which is closing or blocking the peripheral receptor. حتى لو أكو small amount of androgen, which is secreted from adrenal, it will not act because the flutamide or bicalutamide and a lot of alpha, peripheral receptor blocker of the testosterone. So to ensure complete deandrogenization, you have to use combination of either surgical or medical treatment plus peripheral blocker, peripheral receptor blocker. That's about the CA prostate. It's very free. You know the CA prostate. There are books about the CA prostate. CA prostate is common, and there are a lot of researches of the CA prostate. Anyone had any question of the CA about the our subject?
Doctor, CA prostate فقط يصير primary أو ممكن يصير secondary?
It's unlikely to have secondary CA prostate. هو يصير يعني هو برايمري ويصير ميتاستس السكندري بس يعني بروستيت از ا سايت فور سكندري اوف انذر تيومر ما شايف لحد الان ولا لايكلي يعني اذر تيومر ميتاستسايز تو ذا بروستيت
نعم
ولا لايك از يوجوالي برايمري
شكرا دكتور
اكو واحد بعد عنده سؤال Almost all carcinoma arise in the prostate from the duct of acinar secretory epithelium. Squamous transitional adenofibrosarcoma. شو تحلونها؟
Adeno.
Adenocarcinoma. Very good. 95% are adenocarcinoma. Any BSA collection within فراغ week of the prostate biopsy after prostate biopsy or TURB collection within Is get used as estimate tumor marker burden. 2 week, 3 week, 4 week, or 6 week. After TURB or prostatic biopsy. Is get gonna be normal. 1 month, يعني 4 week. Then 4 week is significant. After 4 week, يعتبر هاي الحل مالتها 4 week. The peripheral zone is most frequent site of origin of carcinoma of the prostate and is occurring about how many percent? 60, 70, 80, 90?
70%.
Very good. The gold standard for hormonal therapy in metastatic prostate cancer is bilateral orchiectomy, anti-androgen, the peripheral receptor blocker, or combination therapy. The best is Combination therapy. Which of the following cause initial testosterone release treatment مال prostatic carcinoma we have to decrease the testosterone بس اكو درج منه نطي يسوي initial testosterone release then return to normal. Bilateral orchiectomy, LHRH analog, anti-androgen or diethyl testosterol?
LHRH.
Very good. Single microscopic metastasis focus of prostate cancer فراغ lymph node. Multiple pelvic lymph node is a hallmark, is incurable by any currently available. يعني ما نستعمل اللوكال. ما نستعمل التريتمنت فور لوكالايز، ما نسوي اوركيكتومي، يعني اذا سنجل ميتاستاسيس ايش قد ان تو lymph node، 1 lymph node، 3 اور 4؟ Single lymph node is regarded as metastasis وما نستعمل للوكال. High case 65-year-old male is diagnosed as having prostatic cancer based on transrectal biopsy. سوينا له بايوبسي وعنده طلع كانسر اللي هو كان عنده نوديول بابل سوينا له ديستال ريكتال اكزام نوديول بابل 1 cm. أخذنا لها بايوبسي وطلعت CA prostate which is the following statement are true يعني ردي true false if the tumor confined within the prostatic capsule that tumor confined يعني localized stage A or B radical prostatectomy is an appropriate option true or false ها احنا مو قلنا ذا localized based هو شنو Radical prostatectomy. This is true. إذا localized tumor within the prostate, the best is
radical
prostatectomy. قلت لكم أكو study تقول cryosurgery والradiation هي comparable, but the best is radical prostatectomy. إذا positive lymph node detected on laparoscopic pelvic lymph node dissection, radical prostatectomy is indicated. True or false?
False.
False. Very good. C, radical prostatectomy is invariably associated with impotence. طبعا الـ complication of radical prostatectomy هي impotence و incontinence and stricture. يقول هنا radical prostate is invariably associated with impotence. True or false? مو كلهم يصير عندهم impotence. مو كلهم يصير عندهم. Invariably خطأ. أكو أسأل إن ناوي يسوون selective. يعني preservation of the neurovascular وذلك البيشنت يبقى potent. External beam radiation is an appropriate treatment of the tumor confined the prostate. True or false? That tumor confined the prostate نطي يعني localized نطي radiation. True or false?
False.
True.
احنا قلنا اذا localized اما radiation او cryo او radical prostatectomy. But the best is radical prostatectomy. There is currently no rule for orchiectomy in the management of a prostate cancer. True or false? There is currently no rule for orchiectomy in patient with CA prostate. True or false?
False, doctor.
False, طبعا. One of the options is. أكو واحد بعد عنده سؤال. حقيقة يعني I always said to my student that I feel I am young because of you first and because of my patient. هسه هذا اليانج شوية قل لأنه قبل من أقولها وأنا بيناتكم أشوفكم وأشوف تفاعلكم. هسه هذا عبر النت I'm really not convinced and I hope it is a temporary state that we will return to our lecture hall. قاعة المحاضرات لها فد محبة خاصة للأستاذ وللطالب. أشوفكم وأشوف تفاعلكم طبعا هسه حتى لو أريد مثلا أوصف لكم شلون الديجيتال ريكتال اكزام فور اكزامبل هاو اي فايند هايرد نوديول أو هي سمبل يعني ربري كونسستنسي اوف نورمال. من أسألكم وأشوف ياها المتابع وياها ما متابع وياها اللي يتفاعل. When I looking to your nice faces, أكيد it's much better than I am looking to the laptop. بس هي هاي مرحلة مفروضة علينا وإن شاء الله تعدي على خير. وأتمنى لكم والعوائلكم إن شاء الله الله يخلصكم من هذا الوباء ونعبر هذه المحنة سوية إن شاء الله. أنا أشكركم شكرا جزيلا وإذا ما عندكم سؤال مع السلامة.